Am I the a-hole for not using my inheritance money to help my brother and his family out? Background. Me 19 female and my brother 32 male became orphans 10 years ago due to an accident our parents were in. My parents had always been a bit paranoid when it came to their mortality, so they had set a plan in case they passed. They left a significant amount of money for each of us, and our childhood home was meant to be mine. They specified that we would have access to our share of the will when we turn 18, and since my brother was already old enough, he took his money and cut all contact with me. I'd lived with my grandparents ever since, but last year I finally got my share, so I decided to move into the house and use the money to pay for my studies. I'm in first year of medicine, and it is very expensive. I have estimated that when I finished medicine in 5 years, I'll have a lot of money left to continue with what I want to specialize in, and have some left. My grandparents know my plan, and offered to help with my living expenses, so my inheritance becomes exclusive for my studies until I finish. I accepted, and we have been like this for a year. Now to the issue. My brother and his wife have 3 children from ages 9, 7, and 4. My brother spent his inheritance money on a house, his wedding, cars, and expensive stuff that one doesn't really need to live. My sister-in-law is a stay-at-home mom, so he was the breadwinner. My brother recently lost his job, so now their family's struggling and they need a place to stay. He contacted me to ask for us to meet up. When I arrived, he and his wife were already sat down at a restaurant. Long story short, they said that since they were going through hard times, they expected me to hand them over my house and give them a share of my inheritance so they can get back on their feet. I got pissed off since we have barely talked or visited each other since the accident, and they were just demanding me to pay for them. I told them that I wouldn't, because I already have a plan for the money and I was living on the house. They said I can move back with my grandparents, and blew off at me for being selfish. After arguing, I decided to leave, but now my cousins are saying I'm inconsiderate a-hole and I should help family out. I really need to know if I'm in the wrong, so am I the a-hole? Now for the top comments. Not an a-hole. He has squandered his money. He will squander yours too. Then you'll both be broke. Be responsible with your money, so at least one of you will be financially solvent. Not to mention the fact that Opie's parents died, entire world turned upside down at 9 years old and then the brother leaves as well. Now said brother is calling Opie a selfish a-hole? Wow, you are not the a-hole, Opie. But now my cousins are saying I'm an inconsiderate a-hole and I should help family out. Tell your cousins to offer their homes instead if they actually care that much. Not the a-hole. Also, like, your brother should have downsized by selling off the few expensive stuff he has left to get some money and then imposing on you. Honestly, the audacity. Not today, Hull. Girl, you shouldn't even be here. He got contact with you, and now expects your help? No way. I am begging you to not hand over a cent. He sounds like the type to be given a step and then suddenly take a mile. You owe him nothing. His family is not your responsibility the slightest, so do not allow him to guilt you. Biologically, you're related, but they're not family. And your brother made that decision a long time ago. People love burning bridges not realizing they'll regret it. Thank you. I'm confused as to why Cut contacted the first place, but it's been a decade and I wonder if this will help me build a relationship with him. It will not. As soon as the money's gone, he will be too. Not today, Hall. Now go get those degrees. Thank you. It'll take a lot of time and money, so I can't really afford to pay for him. Besides, if I give him money, I'll have to find another job and it's not the best option with my career choice. If you can't find a job, then so can your brother. Next story. Am I the a-hole for refusing to accommodate my brother's kid ever again? My 17 female older brother, 32 male, has a kid, 3 male, and he treated as the pride and joy of our family because due to some fertility issues, they took 6 years of trying without success. Now that my nephew is here, his parents let him do anything he wants at everyone's expense. My mother had to remove every decoration she had around the house because my nephew used to play with it and wouldn't understand a no. Every little piece she had around the house holds sentimental value. And she had to put it away in order to keep letting my nephew be here because my brother refused to teach him some manners. I couldn't do my homework in the kitchen because my nephew would come and try to take my things, because he wanted to play with them. And even when my brother and his wife hated it, I started to not let him do it, moving him aside or just fight with my brother until he came and took his child. During one of those things, my nephew broke my computer. But I made my brother pay for a new one because I refused to let my dad do it since he wasn't at fault. My brother tried to lecture me about not leaving my laptop there because I knew how his kid was. And I told him to not mess with me and to raise my nephew better or he will be paying for things more expensive than that. My nephew also comes into my room anytime he wants. And I hate when he does that. When he was younger and I had to go to class, I would always tell my brother that my nephew wasn't allowed to come to my room ever. But he would open the door for him and let him wander around just because he could. Now I'm always telling my nephew to get out. And I usually close the door. But he cries and screams all the time. I had enough. So I told my brother to stop expecting me to accommodate this child. If I let my switch, my laptop, or any of my things around the house, I expect them to be where I left them. Because this is my house, and I should be comfortable in my own house knowing that my stuff won't get damaged. And if my nephew does something to them, he has to pay. Always. And that he was a crappy father for refusing to raise him well. Not stay home. Swap out your doorknob for one with a key lock. Lock it when you leave. I had to do this as a teen to keep my thieving sister out. My son acted better at 2, and he was redirected as often as it was necessary. Yes, when you have little visitors over a lot, you make some concessions and move things up higher until they're a little older. But you should not give in to 3-year-old terrorists just because they have lazy parents. Not day hall. If this child is the pride and joy of the family, then his parents should raise him to be that. It takes work. Sounds like his parents are lazy. They call it spoiled for a reason, because he ruined a child for his future success. If you don't give a child consistent consequences for bad behavior, they will never learn any self-discipline and that is disastrous. I realize you can't slap their hands anymore, but that is what we used to do when children touched things they weren't supposed to. It worked. Now it's more work. You have to physically move them away. Give them something else they are allowed to have, give them time out and reward for good behavior. Tell your brother to quit being so lazy. He's not doing his son or himself any favors. Next thing you know, he'll get kicked out of nursery school because he doesn't know how to listen. Then kindergarten, then other kids' families won't want him over to play. That's exactly what my dad has tried to tell them, but they won't listen. My sister-in-law is a stay-at-home mom, and they spend a lot of time in our house because my mom loves to have my nephew around. But she just mostly sits with her phone and expects us to look after him. Most of the time, my nephew will be doing something he's not allowed to do in front of her, with my mom telling him no and she won't lift a finger. I know that 3-year-old tends to be all over everything. But my point is that they won't teach him not to do it. My brother especially tends to let him around my stuff or my room just because he knows it pisses me off. My parents usually go easy on him because he took so long to have a kid and is trying to enjoy him. But my nephew has thrown awful tantrums in public, and they both think it isn't something serious. Now for the next story. Am I the a-hole for telling my sister she should have been more reasonable with her baby registry and not expected to get everything for the baby from it? To start, my dad's side of the family isn't really supportive of wedding/baby showers. Papa's side is very much, if you can't afford to raise a baby, don't have one. There are of course exceptions for things like sudden job loss or house fires. Mama's side is a little more lenient, but they don't do registries. Instead, if you have a bridal shower, your mom tells people if you're doing the kitchen in apples or grapes or bats or whatever. And if you're doing a baby shower, people bring clothes, diapers, books, and other little things. It's meant to be more of a party than a gift-giving thing. We're far more likely to have 8 cousins show up each with a casserole or soup after the baby is born than to have people buy a stroller. Mom's side isn't relevant since we haven't seen her since we were kids. I don't know my brother-in-law's side of the family well, but they seem a lot like mamas with a lot more offers of hand-me-downs thrown in. Well, my sister moved off to the city, and I guess she's used to her friends making these huge registries? She put things on like a $60 bathtub, 4 baby carriers that are $50 each, a pack and play for $250, etc. She then made this big post on Facebook saying that they had worked really hard on the registry and didn't want anything not from it unless it was clothes. On the invitation, she requested a baby book instead of a card and a pack of diapers. So at the baby shower, probably 80% of the gifts were a couple of outfits, a book and diapers. The few other things were mostly from her friends. Mom bought a car seat. You could see my sister's rage slowly building. She ended up leaving early. She spent the next week calling and texting everybody, trying to figure out why we didn't get her anything she wanted. She made a few posts on Facebook, and one of my brother-in-law's aunts offered to buy a $70 pack and play instead, which she turned down. Now my sister is upset and has been aggravating everyone for 3 weeks. She is having to buy all 6 baby containers, swings, sit-me-up floor seats, etc. she wanted, the $300 baby monitor, etc. And everybody is telling her that that's what you do when you have a kid, that you can't expect people to buy everything. Last night, after trying to be patient for over an hour, I snapped. Look, the health department would have mailed you birth control for free. You're having a baby, so it's you guys' job to get the stuff for it, nobody else's. In a way, I'm feeling kind of guilty because she probably wanted to vent. But at the same time, how do you get pregnant and not expect to buy the stuff for the baby? Edit. Someone pointed out that I wasn't clear about my sister's financial situation or whether or not the back and play was going to be used instead of crib due to constraints. She and her husband live in a townhouse. It has a second bedroom which is being turned into a nursery. There was a crib on the registry that does not convert to a larger size. Edit 2. Mom is our stepmom. Dad remarried when we were teens. She's always seen us as her kids, and we've always called her mom. I didn't even think to clarify. Sorry for the confusion. Edit 3. She opened the gifts at the shower, and the clothes ranged from newborn to 18 months. The diaper table was full of things from newborn through size 4. I don't know if that's relevant to anything, but a lot of people seem to think we only got her newborn sizes. Now for the comments. She doesn't need a $60 bathtub. Sinks exist. 4 carriers? Is she going to theme them to what the baby's wearing? She was highly excessive in her asking. Sure, you could have been a little kinder in your wording and just said she can't expect everyone to buy her every single item, but she's the one who is asking people to spend tons of money when she doesn't need all those items. Plus, to turn down a pack and play because it's not the exact $250 she wanted? How rude. Baby doesn't need a $250 one. A $70 would have worked the exact same way. She's expecting everyone else to finance a designer baby and harassing people when they don't want to. Do not buy her anything. I'm giving birth this Thursday, and we are fairly wealthy. I bought most of the baby stuff on Facebook Marketplace and kept my list to the essentials. Yeah, sinks exist, and there are even anti-slip mats you can buy for $10 to make it more comfy for your baby. I got 6 newborn onesies. We have no idea what his size will be. As soon as he's out, we will get more stuff. I don't get people making the whole having a baby about the material things. They just need and love, not a $5,000 nursery. Babies don't care. Not a day home. Suggest that she add a freaking clue to her registry, and people might be willing to chip in and buy her that. Not a day home. Also, maybe it's the culture clash, US to UK, but am I the only one here finds gift registry tacky? Like, if you throw something like a baby shower or wedding, it's to celebrate an important event in your life with the people you love. And if you can't afford it, and are relying on guests' gifts to make up the deficit, don't throw it. Gifts should be at the discretion of the invitees and not mandatory, a gesture or token of appreciation. Giving people a list of pre-approved stuff you want them to get you seems sort of classless and greedy. Or am I way off? Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for not setting up a college fund for my sister-in-law's newest baby like I did for others? Bro passed, leaving Amy and 2 kids behind. I set up a fund for my nieces for college or whatever reasonable path. Then 2 years later, Amy ends up with twins from a one-night stand. I love them, and set them both a fund up too, since no dad in picture. Then Amy marries John. She always said she was done with kids, so it came to my surprise when they said they were trying, as John wants more kids and doesn't believe in birth control. I am their accountant and can fully say that they can't afford it. John is a disabled child, and just above 55% of his checks go to support and medical bills. A week later, I privately sit down Amy and tell her that I have a family myself now, and I'm managing 6 funds, so I just want to give a heads up that I can't afford to start another one. She protested, saying that she expected the fund to be split between all her children. I explained that's not how it works. And each kid will have roughly the same amount in their funds at 17. Oldest is going to school next fall and is promised full costs. Amy then points out she has a partial social security so I can shift that money. But I said no, because it's hers. Same applies to all kids. Amy curses, then kicks me out and goes around telling everyone I'm being cruel and punishing them for being poor. But I never even mentioned her finances. She also said I was favoring bros' kids. Mom yelled at me because I can pay for my wife to lay around at home with a babysitter while willing to punish a kid for just existing. My wife stays at home doing a PhD program with our two toddlers, so hence a babysitter two times weekly. Turns out Amy is pregnant, and this made everyone hate me more, because I ripped out the security from under her. That I stressed her out, and if the baby is harmed, it's on me. That I'm the most well-off, and it wouldn't even sting. Am I the a-hole? I don't want to punish an innocent child, but I don't see why it's on me. I didn't know she was already pregnant and tried to tell her beforehand. But since now it's reality, everyone is telling me I already hate my future niece/nephew. Edit. The twins are 8 now, so it's not like Amy's just popping out children back to back. She always said she didn't want any more kids, and so I was dumbfounded that she was trying. Minus like helping fix a roof or something odd, I do not provide financial support to Amy. The funds are not usually talked about. It is because my mom mentioned something when she heard they were trying, and so I talked to her just to make sure, and slickly put in her brain she can't afford a kid without saying it directly. Not today, Hall. You are an angel for taking care of her twins after your brother passed. It is not on you to provide financial security for her children she cannot fully provide for herself. Right. They're not his/her blood, but it was done anyway. Not today, Hall. This is a hard one. I can see how this would build resentment. But at the same time, do you really want to finance her next 5 kids? Because if her idiotic husband really doesn't believe in birth control, that's at least the number of kids they'll have. You've been plenty generous. Your brother's kids are one thing. You were kind with the one-night-stand twins as they didn't ask to be born. Now she has a new husband, and this is his child, and he should step up. You have zero responsibility. Not today, Hall. I would make sure sister-in-law has zero control over the funds. I'm guessing her security is also trying to get monthly stipends from the kids. I fully control the funds, and will be directly paying the fees to whatever tuition or play/path they choose to take. If there's money left over, they will get it after graduation.